our channel Classfly Community. I hope you all had understood the DC generator. Now we will be moving on to our DC motor. So today we will be know about the working and the principle of the DC motor. Before that, whenever we talk about anything, the first thing is that which strike in our mind is what basically it is. So whenever we say DC motor, so the first query or thing which comes to our mind is that what is DC motor? What is a DC motor? So see, DC motor is a device which converts the direct current. Basically, it converts the electrical energy into mechanical energy. So as here electrical current is a DC, so I have written direct current. So what does it do? DC motor converts direct current into the mechanical work. So here this DC motor is based on the principle of Lorentz law. Now what basically Lorentz law? See, a Lorentz law is a Lorentz law is basically a law which states that the current carrying conductor, so this is a conductor, okay, and this conductor is carrying a current placed in a magnetic field. So you can see there is two magnet and it is moving from north to south, and these are permanent magnets. So there are magnetic fields. So whenever a conductor is there, so and this conductor is having a current, and so it is saying when the current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field, it experiences a force. That means this conductor will experience a torque or a force, and that force is known as Lorentz force. And now we can know the direction of the force by our Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, now let's know what is our Fleming's left hand rule. So see, Fleming's left hand rule says that if I stretch the first finger, so this is my left hand, so if I stretch my fingers like this, so if we stretch the first finger, that is our index finger, so this is my index finger, so it will show you the direction of magnetic field. That means my index finger will show you the magnetic field direction. Okay, and the direction of the current is represented by this second finger, that is our middle finger. So this is my middle finger, so this will show you the direction of the what current, right? Now, and the thumb represents the direction of force experienced by the current carrying conductor. So this will represent you, so this will represent you the direction of what? The force. So this is my index finger which tells you about the magnetic field, my middle finger tells you about the current, and my thumb tells you about what? The force. So this is my Fleming's left hand rule. I have also drawn a small diagram to make you understand. So this is my thumb, so it will represent the force. This red color, that is my index, will represent the magnetic field, and middle finger will represent the direction of the current. So now let's move on. So see, for DC motor I need two magnets. So I have one magnet which is showing north pole, which is in red in color, and another magnet which is in blue color shows me south, and this magnetic field or the field windings will moving from north to south, and I have one armature like this. With this armature I have connected two commutators, and with these commutators there are two brushes. Why I have connected these two commutators, I will be explaining you. With this commutator, there is a DC current which is being connected. So I have represented these red lines as my magnetic field. These two, that is D in shape, are the commutator rings, and beside this D, there are small brushes like this, These are my brushes, okay? So now see, in practical DC motor, flux is created by field winding. So this is my field winding. So here we will have a flux. Flux will be created or it will be generated, and the armature windings will plays a role of current carrying conductor. So this armature will be doing the role of the conductor which will be carrying the current. So now you can see that my DC, this is my higher potential and this is my lower potential. So my current is moving in this direction, right? So why I have put this commutator? So that my direction of the current doesn't change when this armature is rotating and this commutator is also changing their positions. That means this behave as a unidirectional. Okay. So see, when armature windings are connected to a DC supply, an electric current sets up in the winding. That means this armature winding will have an electric current generated whenever there is a DC current here. Now see, the magnetic field be provided by field winding. So these magnets will be providing, or this field windings will be providing me the magnetic field. So in this case, current carrying armature conductors experience a force. That means this armature windings, or this armature will be getting a force or a torque. Okay. Now see, due to the magnetic field, because there is a magnetic field, that why it will have a, it will experience a force or a torque. Now see, commutator. I said commutator, these are the commutators. So whatever I said, I have written in simple languages that commutator is made segmented to achieve unidirectional torque. So on the similar side, we will get a torque. So it will not change the direction. Otherwise, the direction of force would have reversed when the direction of movement of the conductor is reversed in the magnetic field. So it would have, what, so whenever it is moving or it will be rotating like this, it as will, I was saying that the direction of force should not change. That why we are here given these commutators. Okay, now we will move on to our next, that is our direction of rotation of motor. So see, we know that the motor has on the principle of what? That is the Lorentz force. So we know that the Lorentz force equation is what? Or we can see that the magnitude of the force which is experienced by the armature conductor is F equal to BLI. And it will be Newton, because force as a unit is what? Newton. So now see, when B is our magnetic flux density, okay, which is in the generated by the field windings, okay, and L is our active length of the conductor, and I is our magnitude of the current. Now we will determine the rotation of the motor with the help of our Fleming's left hand rule. Now see, there are two magnets and it is moving from left to right, that means from north to south, and this is dotted, that means it is inside the paper, that means my, that means my current will be inside the paper. So as I have said that my, this is my current, so this will be like this, and this is my what? Magnetic field. So this is from this side, it is moving, right? From magnetic field, and it is shown that this thumb will be showing the direction of force. So if my middle finger is my current, this is my magnetic field, that means my direction of force is in this side. So I have represented this arrow in this side, which will show my direction of force. Now see, here my current, the magnetic field is flowing from north to south, but the current is flowing in the outward, that is from outside the paper. So this will be my what? Current, right? This is my magnetic field which is moving, and this will show my direction. So my force is in this direction. Now what I have done, I have changed the pole settings here. So this side is south and this side is north, but the current is inside the paper. So how will I show you this? See, this is my, so if I do like this, so this is my what? This is my current, right, which is going inside the paper. This is my magnetic field as it is moving this side, and this will show my force, right? This will be my direction of force. That's why this is in the upward direction. Now this is outside my what? Outside the paper. But now it is that the poles have been changed, but it is moving from north to south. So this will be my current. So if my current is in this side like this, so this is my current outside, this is my magnetic field, and this is my direction of force. That's why here my direction of force is like this. So I hope you all understood how I have done. So if we want to change the direction of force, if we want to change the direction of forces, so what should we do? Either we should change the direction of the current, either we will change the direction of the current, or it will be inward or upward, or we should change the direction of the current of the armature, or we should change the direction of the field winding, or we must change the pole settings. Okay, now see, we have done the direction of the rotation, right? Now see, to reverse the direction of the rotation, we have done four cases there. So case 1 and case 3, what does it basically state? That case 1, it was moving from to the right. That means it was moving from north to south like this. And case 3, it was moving to the left. That means from north to south. That means the poles have been changed its place. Okay. And the current was in the same direction. That means it was inside the paper, right? But the force is in reverse direction. How is it in reverse direction? What I told? So this was my left hand rule. So as I told, the middle finger will be the inside the paper because it is the current, direction of the current. This is a magnetic line and this is a direction of the force. So this side will be our force, right? Similarly for this, how it will be? As I said, this is my current, so it is inside. This is my magnetic field and this side is my force, this thumb. So this side will be my force here. So these two cases, what does it say? That the case 1 is moving from north to south. Similarly, the case 3 is also moving from north to south, but in the opposite directions. So here the so to reverse the direction, we can see both the forces, both the force direction has been changed, right? This only I have stated before. Similarly for case 1 and case 2, case 2 it was moving to the right. So to the right, that means north to south. That means here the poles, that the direction is same, that is it is moving from north to south. Case 1, similarly for case 1, but here direction of current is vice versa. That means for the case 1, it was what? Yes, it was inside, and whereas case 2, it was outside the paper. So if the case 1 is this, that means this is my magnetic field, the current is moving, and this thumb is my force, so force is in this direction. Now as it outward, so this is like this, so this is my current outward, this is my magnetic field, and this is my force direction. So like this. So today's lecture ends here. So what we learned here, what is a DC motor, how it works, what is its principle, and how we can reverse the direction of the rotation. I hope you all understood. So till then, be happy and have a great day. Now is the code time. Time takes it all, whether you want it to or not. I hope all of you understood today's lecture, and thank you for watching.
Wow, that's impressive. You have completed a magic today. For more videos, subscribe. Join our Facebook group and Instagram page for group discussion and live magus videos for exam preparation in an hour. We start at class like community for students to learn from a friend in a simple way and support them in their own languages. If you are willing to be that one friend who saves us at the exam night preparation, then please join us by visiting classfly.in.